Good afternoon. Nope, start that again. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Welcome to What's Up Vlog 144. I'm just out doing a bit of practice and training on my drone. Really good fun. It's pretty high winds today, but still quite stable. I've got it up to about 250 feet up in the air, which I'd set as a limit because I was a bit scared, quite frankly. But it's still, considering the wind, handled it really well. It's very controllable. The only thing I did do, which was really stupid, is I did the auto landing to come back to where I was standing, which it did perfectly, but I hadn't spotted. I was standing pretty close. You see how steep these curbs are. I was standing a bit close to the curb, and as it landed, the blade missed the curb by like that much, which was a little bit frightening. So I'm pretty sure that would have just ripped the blade off. Anyway, so I'm out here with my faithful camera lady using the Karma grip now. So hopefully this is all nice and steady and smooth footage. We'll really see in a minute because we've got to climb over a fence. So it'll be interesting to see how steady that stays. Workout day again today. I'm falling well behind my arch nemesis, Jesper Anker, who I believe is doing his FTP test today. So good luck with that, Jesper. I will try and catch that on your live stream. We both said it was a big mistake live streaming our FTP test, and you clearly haven't learned from that mistake, you foolish, lanky Dane. So, good luck with that. I've got family duties, but hopefully I'll have time to catch at least some of that. And then I'm going to jump on FRNKLN Bespoke Workout Week 5 Workout 2, I think it must be. So, like I say, I'm falling quite behind on the workouts, but I'll do my best to catch up over the next week or so. That's it, yeah. So no real reason for being out here doing it outside, other than the fact that Millie's got the GoPro Karma stick, and I've been practicing with the GoPro Karma drone, and that's it. Right, I'm going to cut to being nice and warm in my kit and on my bike. So here we are again. FRNKLN Bespoke workout time. Week 5, workout 2. I've fallen behind schedule again. Not my fault this time. Just had far too much on. Right, I mentioned in the introduction that Jesper was doing his FTP test. I've now watched him do his FTP test, and as much as it pains me to say it, chapeau, my friend. That is the most impressive FTP test I've watched on Zwift. You dug so deep. The figures, so the number, the final number was a new FTP of 302 watts, which puts Jesper in the A category, if my maths are correct. So, absolutely stunning work. It means I've got a hell of a job to get anywhere near you. I've worked that out as being about a 16% increase in your FTP. So for me to achieve the same, I need my FTP to be 258 watts or above. I think that's correct anyway. Obviously, regular viewers will know my math is not the best, but that's the way I've calculated it. I will do an FTP test soon. That's not what I'm doing tonight. I'm not going to tell you when I'm doing it. I'm certainly not going to live stream it. I'll just keep that one to myself this time. I put far too much undue pressure on myself last time. So today is a case of trying to actually sort of panic train to get my fitness levels up to compete. We're halfway through this training competition with myself and Jesper. And yeah, he's doing well, the kid. he's doing really well, so I've got my work cut out. Anyway, enough of that. Let's get on with what we're here to do. So, squeaky voice, let's run through FRNKLN Workout WKG Week 5 Work 2.
Week 5 started with some nice sweet spots. Now, taking the learning from the last workout, we're going to try some more perceived effort. So the idea here is you're made to do 80% by erg mode, and then you have to do it yourself in the free ride period. This builds up from 80 to 90 and then 100%. We then sit around 90% and the top end of the sweet spot to see if we can apply what we've learned. Some advice for the workout is don't get too concerned about holding the numbers in the free riding period. It's a test to see if your brain and legs can communicate to understand what 80%, then 90%, and then finally 100% feels like. You can hold whatever cadence you like, just be aware of your heart rate and your breathing. Stress point 60, author FRNKLN Bespoke.
Okay, so the numbers aren't too frightening in terms of the power output required, but it's going to be a case of me recognising how or whether I'm putting out those numbers without actually having the information there or erg mode to control that power for me. So that's an interesting test. Incidentally, on erg mode, following various discussions and a brilliant video that Darren Hunter uploaded showing the benefits of the power smoothing directly through the Elite app, I've gone in, I've checked that I've got the latest firmware, that's fine, and I have put 10 second power smoothing through the Elite mobile app into my Elite driver. So hopefully that makes this graph a little bit smoother. We'll wait and see. Anyway, no putting it off any longer. Let's get straight on the workout. I have chosen flat route of Richmond. Once again, a bit of solitude and also nice flat roads to make sure I'm not distracted by hills and gradients. So I'm going to shut up now because I'm going to take this 3-minute warm-up period quite seriously to make sure my heart rate is nice and low by the time we start the harder efforts. All right, I have no idea if my warm-up was done sensibly. It's my heart rate monitor. As soon as I sat up, decided I've had enough. I'll be starting off with some sprints, 255 watts. Slightly smoother on that graph, I would have said, for the erg mode. Not perfect. The numbers on the screen are still flicking around all over the place, but the actual graph at the bottom looks a little smoother. I'd like to know what my heart rate's at. Okay, so we've got six of these 255 watt sprints. Here we go again. So that's the 255 done. Heart rate's still not working. I fiddled about with it. Can't get it to come on. Got a 4-minute ramp up now. Erg mode doesn't seem any better either. Oh, I don't know. I think it's the way I pedal. But right. So we're ramping up from 120 for 4 minutes. Okay, so that's the 4-minute ramp. My heart's hovered around 150 to 153 beats per minute. And what we're going to do now is 5 minutes at 180 watts, which is 80% of my threshold. And then I believe I'm going to be doing the same again, but without erg mode. So see how this works out. Okay, heart rate's at 159 BPM, according to my watch. So it's the only way to monitor at the moment, which is a real pain, but it's better than nothing. At this pace and this cadence, erg mode actually does seem a little bit more steady. And that green line there at the bottom of the screen actually is pretty smooth for me. So maybe this 10 second smoothing is doing something. But it's not sort of kicker smooth, but I'm not sure it ever will be. Okay, so 180 watts, 5 minutes done. My heart rate popped back for a moment, hovering around 159, 160. Now I've got to do 180 watts for another 5 minutes, but I believe without the benefit of erg mode. Oh, it's just gone very loose. Okay, heart rate's back. There we go. Found a nice rhythm now. while I'm here, and I've just seen an email pop up from Bob completing another Raz segment. Just want to say congratulations to Ruth Ambrose, our latest rider to be entered into the Hall of Fame of Razzers. One of only three female Razzers, am I right? But Ruth, well done. Congratulations. Congratulations to all of you guys and girls. It's just stunning commitment, determination, and effort. And I'm finally starting to get the times up on the leaderboard. I think I've got Simon Romain topping it at the moment, but there is a feeling that might be short-lived as soon as I do Evelyn Ayres' time, which I did start doing the other day and got completely distracted, so apologies. It's a more drawn-out process than even I realised. Just double-checking and triple-checking everything. Thank you to Peter Wilson again for the umpteenth time, but I can't overstate how brilliant the spreadsheet is that Peter provided, which makes things a lot more reliable and more straightforward for me. But it's still pretty time consuming when I'm having to stop and start with other commitments, but I will get there, I promise. But Ruth, well done on completing it. No one can ever take that away from you now. You're officially a Razzer. So well done. All right, back to the workout. Okay, so we're back in erg mode now at 200 watts for the next 5 minutes. My heart rate's been pretty steady around 170, 171. I'm gonna try and relax it down a little bit if I can, because this will effectively be 10 minutes at 200 watts now. First one on erg mode, second one free riding. Here we go again. It's going to come out of erg mode. I've just got to try and keep that power for the next 5 minutes, just by feel and muscle memory. I can tell you that my heart rate is still around 168. In fact, that was a couple of minutes ago, so let's look. 46 apparently. Oh no, there we go, 170. So I stayed reasonably steady, which isn't too bad. I'm quite pleased with that. Obviously I'm expecting it to shoot up on this next block at 225. But if I can keep it at 170 for this entire 5 minutes, I'll be quite pleased with that. Now I've got to try and get the power up a little bit. There we go. Alright, here comes the really fun bit. 10 minutes at threshold. First with erg mode, then without. Whew! Heart rate currently 172. Yeah. Right, so I had to pause again for a minute. So disappointing. I got to the end of the 225 block, and then before starting on the 6 minutes at 200, I had to take a minute and pause the workout for a minute. I just felt absolutely horrendous. I'm actually getting quite worried now because 225 is my threshold. And I held it for 10 minutes there and just felt horrible. And I couldn't, I did similar to the last time. I let my cadence drop as soon as that 225 block was finished. I just didn't have the strength to get it back up again to find the 200 watts. So I just had to pause. Wasn't a long pause, but long enough to be pretty disappointing. So I am genuinely concerned about why I'm feeling a bit like this at the moment. Last couple of workouts, or the last one, I felt much better. Maybe that was just a much easier workout. But yeah, this one started nicely. Same old thing. Got 5 minutes into the 225. And was already, my heart rate was already quite high. I was feeling it. But it just took a very sudden dive. I literally could not muster the power to do 200 watts even without having a quick break. So, oh, this doesn't bode well. I think I'm gonna have to look into a little bit more thoroughly into my eating patterns, sleep. I know sleep's rubbish, but that's no excuse. That was just a couple of these workouts recently have just got the better of me. So maybe I need to wait for my results to come back from the physiology optimization organization. They'll tell me what I'm doing wrong. But yeah, don't feel good about that at all. It's not good. Never like to pause a workout or have to take a break in a race or a ride. But honestly, I just couldn't do it. So anyway, that kind of summarizes the workout for you. I'm just winding down now. Heart rate monitor's finally started to work. Always useful at the end of a workout. Yeah, tough one that, but certainly didn't seem tough. The numbers on paper look very doable, and I have a feeling it should have been very doable. I'm not entirely sure why I collapsed so badly, but it's one of those things. Move on from it and try and improve for the next one. So that's my summary. Thank you, Tim. Very misleading workout that, right from the start, but I got all the stars, so the workout is in the legs, even if I pause for, I don't know what, 90 seconds, something like that, maybe a bit more. But the effort is still there, so hopefully I'm still benefiting from it. Yeah, that's it. I can't, well, nothing else to say. Well done, Jesper, again for your FTP. Absolutely blown away by that, my friend. Stunning. So thank you all for watching. I hope I'm not demotivating you all too much. It's demotivating for me, I tell you, but I'm starting to believe there's something I'm doing wrong not to be progressing more than I am. But we'll see. Anyway, thank you all for watching, and I'm going to go and cry, and I'll see you on the next one. Ciao.